Famine is the admission of collective failure. It is not when we should act. We should act way before the famine so people don't starve and people don't die of hunger-related causes. So for us, famine is the F word. For us, we must act way before that happens. Famine is a technical term. We say there is a famine when three conditions come together in a specific geographic area. First, at least 20% of the population in that particular place must be facing extreme levels of hunger. Second, 30% of the children in the same place must be wasted. They are too tall for their weight. So they're very skinny, basically. And the third condition is that the mortality rate must double from the average of, for adults, 1 person per 10,000 per day to 2 people per 10,000 per day. When these three conditions come together, we say it's a famine. IPC is essentially a way to simplify food security data, nutrition data, mortality data, in a way that decision makers can understand and make decisions. IPC then essentially is taking people in a given place and putting people in 5 different categories. IPC 1 means everything is okay. The IPC phase 2 is that some part of the population may be under stress. And then we go to the third level, IPC phase 3, crisis. What that means is, so suddenly you don't have enough to either eat or what you are eating is not diverse enough. And then you get into the fourth phase, IPC phase 4, emergency. This is where you don't have enough to eat. This is where malnutrition rates are significantly higher. And this is where mortality is slightly started to go up. And then the last and the final category is IPC phase 5, which we call either famine or catastrophe. This is where all these indicators which I've mentioned, they are at their extremist levels. So what we are trying to do as World Food Program and other humanitarian agencies is to help people starting from crisis level onwards to save people's lives so that they don't get to IPC phase 5. Today's famines are different than what we experienced in the 70s or the 80s in Ethiopia, because then famines were driven by droughts. Today's famines, or risks of famines, are largely driven by conflict. Whether it is Sudan, whether it is Yemen, whether it is Gaza, it is all conflict. So if we are going to avoid these famines, the easiest way would be to stop the conflicts. But if that is going to take time, or that is not going to happen tomorrow, then it is our responsibility that we are able to feed the innocent people. 20 years ago, there was Darfur crisis, which happened in Sudan. Everybody in the world knew about it. And thankfully, because of that global attention, we did not experience a famine back in 2003-04. Today, the situation is probably several times worse, but there is just not enough global attention on what is happening over there. So the likelihood of famine over there is real. In order to avoid that, what we need is 2 things. 1, access, physical access into Sudan, wherever people are in need, and 2, enough financial resources so that we can help them. Several years ago, when bad things happened in certain places, we could say, "I'm sorry, I did not know." Today, we see crises in real time. So we cannot say we did not know. According to our estimations, 309 million people in 72 countries are in crisis or worse level of hunger. And there is a huge shortage of financial resources to address those. And that must change.